Hello, Harold Dick again, and I'm here again with JMP. I have a data set called Freshman 1, and it has these 8 variables. They've been already given a sense. In other words, the return variable is the dependent Y variable. The other variables are going to be my X variables, my independent variables. I'm trying to predict return based on these other 7 variables. And so you see return is a dummy variable, a dichotomous variable. It's either 0 or 1. 1 for returning for their sophomore year, 0 for not returning. And in this problem, we're going to need to try to predict whether the freshmen return for their sophomore year. The other variables include their freshman GPA, how many miles from home they are, what college they are in, science, business, etc., where they live, on campus, off campus, on a dorm, other, how many hours of part-time work they have, do they attend office hours or how frequently, and their high school GPA. We're going to use those 7 variables to try to predict the retention of freshmen to their sophomore year. This is an important concept for universities. They're always trying to retain students that they've gone to a lot of expense to recruit. Retention rates get published in various publications and they get ranked according to their retention rates. So universities are very concerned about retention rate. I'm going to use a technique, it's called partitioning in JMP. It's sometimes known as a classification technique. I'll start by clicking on Analyze, Modeling, Partition, and you see that I have 100 students, and I'm going to click on this red triangle to display the counts, and you see I have 23% of my freshmen don't return, 77 out of the 100, 77% do return. And I'm going to ask for a split best, and the algorithm goes out and checks all 7 variables to see which one best predicts whether they return or not. The red is a metaphor for not returning. The blue means that they do return. So the size of this bar that's blue or red sort of corresponds to how many return or don't return. What JMP has done is found that among all the variables, GPA is the variable that best predicts whether they return or not. In fact, it's not only found that variable, but what I call a cut point. The cut point where the GPA is bigger than 1.0159, those students went off into this branch of the tree. The students that are less than 1.0159 went off to the right. We had 11 students go to the right. All 11 of them did not return. We had 89 students went to the left with the higher GPA. Out of those 89, 12 didn't return. The 77 did. I can split individual end nodes. These are my 2 end nodes for the tree. Or I can go up here, this red triangle, and just say split best. It'll go off and decide which split to happen next. And it split this end node into 2 new end nodes, where on the left we have business, liberal arts, sciences, engineering students, and on the right the College of Social Sciences. And you see that all 11 of the ones that were in, or actually 11 out of 12 of the students that did not return went to the right, only one of them went to the left. So knowing that they were in social sciences with a higher GPA meant that they were less likely to return of all the students with the higher GPA. You'll also notice that we have a graph that shows you how the partitioning is happening. We have the split between low and higher GPA, and over here we have the social sciences, whether they return or not. The ones are up here, the zeros are down here. So this is the partitioning of the whole data set in the same sense that the tree does. Let's try another split, split best, and it split this end node into two according to whether the GPA was less than or greater than 3.624. So we can go back and use the same variable again. To be in this end node must mean that they have GPA bigger than 1.0159 but less than 3.624, and they're in the College of Social Sciences. So what that means is that if for each of the end nodes, and we have four end nodes right here, each end node will have a rule that tells us whether a student ends up in that which of these four end nodes. These students all have higher GPA and are in one of these colleges. Students that end up in this end node have a GPA that's between 1.0159 and 3.624, and they're in the social sciences college. These students have a GPA bigger than 3.624. I don't have to mention this because if they're bigger than 3.624, they're also bigger than 1.0159, and they are in the College of Social Sciences. And finally, these students over here, these 11 students that didn't return, had GPAs in their freshman year less than 1.0159. Let's do another split, split best, and we ended up splitting this end node into two. And we can continue splitting. And I just wanted to show you that at some point, perhaps it doesn't make sense to do more splits. This end node only had one that didn't return to go off and decide what best predicts whether they don't return or not. Might not make much sense because this is only a sample, and probably don't have that level of accuracy for one student. And so this leads to the idea of overfitting. We're doing more splits than we needed to. If I had fewer splits, it'd be underfitting rather than overfitting. We're trying to find out the correct or the number of splits that makes the most sense. I'm going to go up here and prune below. I'll prune the tree, get rid of that last split. Perhaps this looked like a good one, or I could say split at this point if I wanted to, but perhaps it doesn't really help. I don't have a lot of students there. I'm going to unsplit, prune that branch. So the principle that I'm trying to illustrate here is one that's referred to as Occam's razor. Occam's razor has the idea that if we have two models that have equal predictive ability, we should choose the simpler model. Occam was a 11th, 12th century monk that first espoused this principle. You can read about it. His name is spelled different ways. O-C-C-A-M, I think, might work. Another name for this principle is the principle of parsimony. That means a more parsimonious model is one that has less complexity. And the third name I use here is called the KISS principle, to keep it simple, stupid model, which I continually have to remind myself about. So this is actually a fairly simple principle here. The idea, the usefulness of the classification technique is that it's easy to explain to people and to your boss or people that you need to explain it to. That just here's how the rule came about, and it might not make a whole lot of sense, but the rule pops out and there you have it. You could partition your data set into a learning set and into a test set to see how good your model is. Or you could do multiple resampling like that and create multiple models to see how stable your model is. So here we have partitioning in JMP, a classification technique, has a dependent variable and one of many data mining techniques. So thank you.